this is Tim from InstantPianoGenius.com, and I've been a professional keyboard player for 20 years. I've been on stage about 7,000 hours total playing piano, and I've been in rehearsal and recording studios with top-notch musicians who have also played with Journey, Rick Springfield, Billy Idol, Melissa Etheridge, Alice Cooper, Richard Marx, Michael Jackson, Boz Scaggs, Barry White, Nancy Wilson, Aretha Franklin, Michael McDonald, Kenny Loggins, Elvis Costello, Macy Gray, and dozens of others. I'm a working musician, not a piano teacher. I know exactly what you need to know to become a professional keyboard player or just how to sound like a pro as quickly as possible. Professional musicians don't talk about chords very much. They use a number system that your piano teacher probably won't even show you. In the next few minutes, I'm going to quickly teach you more about how to actually play the piano than you've probably learned taking lessons for months. Here's why I say if you can count to eight, you can become an instant piano genius. In fact, if you're not using this numbering system, you're wasting your time and effort. I'm going to move quickly, so watch this multiple times if you need to. Let's get started. First, hand fingering. When I talk about fingers, I'm going to count thumbs as being one, then the next finger out being two, three, four, and little fingers being five. So just keep that in mind when I'm talking about fingering. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, and five. Next, on the piano, there's white notes and black notes, but they're all the same. Just think of them as being equal. And a half step is going from any one note to another note that's right next to it. So here to here is a half step. From here to here is also a half step. From here to here is also a half step. So it doesn't matter if it's white or black, just adjacent notes are a half step. Now a whole step means that there's a note in the middle. So from here to here is a whole step because this note is in the middle. From here to here is a whole step, of course, because there's a note in the middle. Here to here, just a half step. And from here to here is also a whole step because this note is in the middle. So just ignore the fact about some being white and some being black. A whole step means there's a note in the middle. A half step means there is no note between the two notes. Now, recognizing the notes on the piano, you probably already know that it goes from A to G, but just in case you don't, in order to find where the A is, you look for any cluster of three black notes and draw a line from the center black note out, and the A is right to the right of that line. So this is A. Now it just counts up sequentially in white notes. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And once you get to G, then it comes around back to A. And you can tell this is an A because there are the three black notes again, and you draw the line out, that's the A. So as you can see right there, this is an A, this is an A, this is a B, this is a C. And this is called, this is C, it's also called the center C. And C is found by either counting up from the A or taking the two black notes and then going to the left of the left one, and that's a C. And the reason that people use middle C is that a major scale in C uses all white notes, so it's a good place to start. So, more importantly than the notes I just showed you, and now let's get into the numbering system now. Instead of going A, B, C, D, E, F, G, if we're playing an A, I'm going to think of it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And once we've gone from A to G, and this is 7, we come back to A, so this would be 8. So this A is a 1, and this is an 8. And that's why I say if you can count to 8, you can be an instant piano genius. Now you could also think of this 8 as a 1 if you're going to continue on up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so now let's take middle C. This is the C, and if we were going to play a C major scale, it's in all white notes. So now, because we're talking about C, we're going to make the C 1. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And now I'm going to show you how you can play any major scale easily. Okay, a major scale is all whole notes, meaning you're going from here to here. That's a whole step because there's a note in between. Here to here is a whole step. So the only time in a major scale where there are half notes is between the 3 and the 4 and the 7 and the 8, okay? Besides the 3 and the 4 and the 7 and the 8, every other note is a whole step. So once you know 3, 4, and 7, 8 are the only half steps, to play C, you go 1, 2, 3, and then from 3, 4 is a half step. And then you go whole step, whole step, whole step, and then from 7 to 8 is a half step. Now you can apply that to anything. So let's play a major scale in D. There's going to be black notes in it, but we know that the only half steps are between 3, 4, and 7, 8, right? So we're going to go whole step, whole step. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, and then from 3 to 4, we're going to do a half step. So we know it goes to here. Then we're going to go whole step, whole step, whole step. And then we know that from 7 to 8 is a half step. So we're gonna go from here to here. So as long as you remember 3, 4, and 7, 8 are the only half steps in a major scale, you have just learned how to play any major scale. Now, minor scales. A minor scale is all whole notes except between 2 and 3 and 5 and 6, between 2 and 3 and 5 and 6. So the A minor scale happens to be all white notes. So let's take a look at that. So we're gonna play a minor scale. It sounds sadder than a major scale. Okay, so we're gonna make this 1 because we use the 1 for wherever we're starting with. So 2 and 3 and 5 and 6 are the only half steps. So we're gonna go 1, 2, and then from 2 to 3 is a half step. And then we're gonna go 4, 5, and then from 5, 6 is a half step, and then it's all whole steps, 7, 8. Now that we know that, we can play any minor scale. So let's do it in E, okay? So this is an E, so we know it's whole steps except between 2, 3, and 5, 6. So this is E minor, 1, 2, and then from 2 to 3 is a half step, then 4, 5. Now we know between 5 and 6 is a half step, 6, and then 7, 8. Now, that's how you play any minor scale. Now, here's some excellent news. You don't really have to play those scales very much. I'm not going to push you to be able to play those scales, but now that I've shown you that, you can do it. So you know how to find that information. So let's move on. Do you know the difference between a major and a minor chord is? A major chord sounds happy, and a minor chord sounds sad. Can you tell the difference? Okay, so here's how to play any major chord. We're gonna use C because C is all white notes, so it's easier to see. But a major chord uses the 1, 3, and 5. So you're gonna use your 1, 3, and 5 fingers, and also you're gonna use the 1, 3, and 5 notes in a major scale. So we can find out that the notes in this major scale in C are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're just gonna use 1, 3, and 5. All right, so here's how you can figure out how to play any major scale. Just look at how many notes are in between each of these chords. Between the 1 and 3, there are 3 notes, 1, 2, 3. And between the 3 and 5 are 2 notes, 1 and 2, all right? So now that we know that, we can play any major scale. It's just the 1, 3, and 5, and you're gonna be leaving 3 notes between the 1 and 3, 2 notes between the 3 and 5. Now, once we can play C, playing F and G are exactly the same. They're all white notes. So if I leave my hand like a claw and slide up, I can play F, 1, 3, 5, 3 in between, 2 in between, and I can play G. I know it's G because that's the note that my thumb is on. That's a G. That's a G major. Now, we can play any major chord. So let's try to play a D major. Okay, we know our thumb's gonna go on D, and then if we don't know what notes to find, we're just gonna count up 3, 1, 2, 3, put our 3rd finger there, and then we're gonna count up 2, 1, 2, and put our 5th finger there. Okay, so that is a D major. Now that we know the D, if we make our fingers hand like a claw, we can also play an E and an A, because they're exactly the same. Slide up and move over, that's an E chord, we know it is because that's where my thumb is, and then slide up again, that's an A chord, I know that because that's where my thumb is, all right? You can do that with any major chord. Just leave 3 notes in between your 1st and 3rd, 2 notes in between your 3rd and 5th. Easy as that. Now, how to play any minor chord. The only difference between a major and a minor chord is that the 3rd finger plays 1/2 step lower, okay? So to change a C major chord into a C minor chord, you just take your 3rd finger and you move it down 1/2 step. So when you look at the spaces in between for a minor chord, you've got 2 keys in between your 1st and 3rd finger, and 3 keys in between your 3rd and 5th finger. Now that you know that, you can play any minor chord. If you can play C minor, by freezing your hand in a claw, you can slide up and play F minor. You can also play G minor. Now an A minor has no black notes in it. We know this is an A minor because our thumb is on the A. There's 2 spaces in between the 1st and 3rd finger, and there's 3 spaces in between 3rd and 5th finger. Now that I can play A minor, I can play D minor. I know that's a D because my thumb's there. And E minor. I know that's an E minor because my thumb is there. And that's how you can play any minor key. Just put your thumb on the first note that you're trying to play, and then pick out the spaces. It's as simple as that.